Texas. Number 10, Dylan Cox. At guard, 6'4", junior, Mission Viejo, California. Number 21, Kyle Wilson. At center, 6'10", junior, out of Berkeley Heights, New Jersey. Number 31, Kellen Ferguson. At 4, 6'7", junior, out of Cucuanago, Wisconsin. Number 32, Tanner Plum. And at 4, 6'6", junior, out of St. Louis, Missouri. Number 33, Lowry Scooby. Coaching staff, 4 Army, athletic intern, 2nd Lieutenant Josh Herman. Assistant coaches are Jimmy Allen, Sean Matiliano, Justin Jennings, Brandon Linton. And in his 6th season at Army, the head coach, Zach Spiker.
Time, the assistant chef, Rafferty, Phil Martelli Jr., and Chris Cheeks. They'll go to the starting lineup of Corey Holden, who Bill just mentioned. Kasman Hayes, leading scorer on the team with 16.6 points per game. The three forwards, Maurice Jeffers, Devon Pickard, who's shooting 41% from three over the last three games, and Eric Carter started for the first time against Villanova, had 6 points and 5 rebounds in that contest. How about that for a freshman? Where was your first game you started? At the Wells Fargo Center against a top 10 team. Not bad for Eric Carter. We expect a lot from him in the future. The officials in this game, Tony Chiazza, Tim Kelly, and Tony Crisp. West Point comes to Delaware having beaten the Hens 13 of 15 matchups, although Delaware on the road last season got an 89-74 win against the Black Knights. Army comes out with West Point across the chest with the gold lettering black uniforms. Delaware with the home whites for the first time this season, and the blue lettering. Delaware will go left to right away from their home bench. West Point right to left to begin this game. The jumpers, Kevin Ferguson and Maurice Jeffers, and we are ready to begin here at the Bob Carpenter Center for the home opener of Delaware basketball. Ball in the air, and it's in the hands of Corey Holden after Delaware wins the jump. Holden goes right side to Delaware's leading scorer, Kasman Hayes, on the right wing. Pass to Carter, back to the point guard, Holden. 24 to shoot, couple dribbles as they run the offense. Hayes a ball fake, Wilson defending him. Top scorer on top scorer is that matchup. Now Pickard's first touch, they work it to Jeffers. Back to Holden it goes. Holden, elbow jumper was there, instead pass it off to Pickard. And Pickard, stay hot, kid! Shooting above 40% from beyond the arc over the last three, and he makes his first attempt of the night from long range. Delaware up 3-0, and it's Army's first possession now as they'll work the ball around the perimeter. Dylan Cox, he makes this offense go. He runs it, one dribble for Ferguson, and a bounce pass to Tanner Plum. Corner, open three, Larry Toomey cannot answer. Long rebound, tracked down by Devon Pinkard, and Delaware wants to run. Here's Hayes, doesn't have numbers. Corner, Holden thought about the three, he'll pull it back out.
And there's the experience coming through. Holden realizing he didn't have a great look, draws the ball out, runs some offense. A great delivery to Pinkard on that first possession.
An assist already for Holden. Pass inside to Carter, bobbled, and a turnover. Don't know if that'll go to Carter or Holden, who had seven against Villanova. Second possession for Army. Delaware up 3-0. Corner, Toomey. Missed a three on the first possession, did Toomey. Now extended left elbow. It goes to Ferguson. Wilson, Toomey again open from three. Second try is good this time around. And he's not going to miss twice. That wide open for Montgomery.
Army runs an exchange. Delaware is trying to jump switch it and hold Wilson off so he can't turn in the middle. That leaves Toomey wide open in the corner. Delaware's got to rotate off the bottom and challenge the shot.
Toomey now 3 of 11. On the season from long range after missing the first and making that one. We're tied at 3, 18-13, and Holden unbreaks that time early with the layup on the right side. It's 5-3 Delaware. Now Army with it. Working it back to Toomey, couple dribbles, and the point guard Dylan Cox on top. Ferguson gets a touch as he pops out to the elbow. And now it's Kyle Wilson, the best scorer in the Patriots, showing why a triple off the handoff from Ferguson.
Kasman Hayes got rubbed on a little side screen on the left-hand side of the court as we look at it. Hayes has got to stay located with him throughout, or they've got to switch a little bit quicker from the top screen.
Now a 5-second violation called against Pigger. Looked like he wasn't expecting the full court pressure as they doubled Holden, and Hayes was not in a position to come get the ball.
Though Army picked Delaware up on the first possession, he's got to be more aware of the surroundings.
Toomey, another open look from three, missing. No one boxes out Ferguson. Ball fake, layup, and just like that, Army on a quick 5-0 run to make it 8-5, 17-32. First half action, and Army will set up that full court pressure once again.
Ferguson is long. He gets good position, but not a bulky interior player. Delaware's got to be sure they get somebody rotated to the weak side and block him out. Both people came at him, in particular Mo Jeffers tried to block the shot. Ferguson used a ball fake. Delaware's got to stay down on the ground, try not to block his shot and more affect it or block him out initially.
Inbound goes the hole. Down the right sideline he goes, and he'll set up the offense. Ferguson shoots 68% on the season, probably because a lot of his shots look like that. Too close for comfort for Dylan Cox as he reaches in. That's his first and the team's first.
Dylan Cox is the most aggressive on-the-ball defender Army has. I think Kyle Wilson's defense has improved significantly. He's drawn Kasman Hayes. But look for Cox to look and see if he can't pick Corey Holden off when he crosses over.
Baker the inbound, right sideline. Tough spot to inbound the basketball from, but he gets it into Hayes. Hayes in the corner, brings it out near the center circle. Wilson, good defense on him. Hayes, the runner, floats off the side of the backboard. Not a good look for Kasman Hayes. It's in the hands of Kyle Wilson. Wilson to the corner. It's Plum. Plum lets the three fly. That's a miss, but another offense rebound for Army. It was Luke Morrison that time. Kick out to a reserve that got in Maxwell Lennox, one of the captains. He misses, and back to Delaware it goes.
Maxwell Lennox is not a three-point shooter. He should pass that up and drive the ball, but an excellent ball defender.
You're right, Lennox, one of six this season from long range after that one. Hayes, good shooter inside the arc that time, missing. Carter crashing, powers up and through. The freshman uses all 230 pounds of his frame to get that one back up and in.
Carter works very hard on the offensive glass, gets good position, and what I love there is he's able to finish through pressure.
Pull-up jumper, quick shot for Army, is missed. Delaware with a chance to retake the lead early. It's 8-7, Army on top. Holden, corner, Pinker. They're trying to work it inside. Back to Carter. Can't go to him. And now Holden back out.
Army plays man-to-man and fronts the post down low.
Holden, pull-up jumper deep. Two is good. Corey Holden gives Delaware the advantage, 9-8.
Holden is able to shoot over Lennox, who is 4 inches shorter than him. Did a good job of recognizing that matchup.
Now a three-point shot on the way off the mark. That one coming from Luke Morrison. They'll let him fly here, Army, early from long range.
Army would just as well shoot it in transition as they do off their set offense.
Now it's Pinkert on the wing. 15-50, first half. Media timeout will come at the next whistle. Pinkert playing with it, top of the key, gets it to Carter. He's looking to pass, back door to Pinkert. Pinkert bobbles it, allows Army to set their defense back up, but he's fouled. And he'll shoot two free throws when we come back. 15-40 remaining in the first half. Delaware up 9-8.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice.
Dark.
Moving forward.
I'm here because this is my home. Delaware pride. You can say I have that. It's bigger now. The state is across my chest. Now it's about all of us. Now I am a Blue Hen. Experience it.
Next to Bill Harmon, welcome to you to Newark, Delaware for the first time this season as the Hens' home opener. And Delaware off to maybe their best start of the season. This is a squad that shoots just 30% from the field. They're 4 of 6 from the field today. Some home cooking, some home rims serving Delaware well to start this basketball game.
It started off with Pinker getting the ball in exactly his favorite spot at exactly the right time from Corey Holden. Makes the three, gets him off extremely well. Holden realizes he has a matchup advantage, is able to score over top of Maxwell Menix. Carter gets an offensive rebound inside and is able to finish, and that was a great set play. They had two elbow post players. They run Pinkert off a back screen on the weak side. Carter delivers a perfect pass to him and gets Pinkert the ball in a great position. So I really like what Delaware's doing early on. They've done a great job of getting back in transition. They have left a couple players open, but that's a little bit of their youth trying to figure out exactly how to play this motion offensive army. But I think Delaware is off to a very positive start.
Pinkert started the game with a made three-point shot. Now at the free throw line, as the second foul was called against Army, and Pinkert, a good free throw shooter, historically at least, misses both free throws, and the Hens keep their lead 9-8. 15-28, first half. Some subs in for the Military Academy, and Luke Morrison lets it fly for three again, and misses. Army just 2 of 7 from downtown so far tonight. Back to Delaware go. A turnover, though, another one. That's the third for Delaware. And Mo Williams running the basketball on the right wing in front of Delaware's bench. Morrison drives, knocked away by Hayes. Morrison gets it back, though, and lobs it cross court. And a foul is going to be called against Delaware. That's the first on the Hens. And it goes against Sky Johnson. That's his first.
Delaware's done quite a good job, other than that first shot in which Ferguson got good position underneath, of defending their defensive glass. They're getting four or five people to the glass. They're being very physical in their blockouts, which you have to do. Army is very aggressive. Not a huge team, but they use their size to get great position, especially on the weak side. Delaware so far is up to the task.
And you weren't lying about me getting tested early with this roster. I have a sheet that I make. It's a pretty in-depth sheet with stats and player notes on them. I have 19 guys listed on my sheet. Kennedy Edwards, who just made 1 of 2 free throws, didn't make the cut. But he's in the game, and obviously in the box score as he makes 1 of 2 free throws. Edwards, again, his first playing time of the season for an Army team that travels with about 20 guys over there on the bench. They had to get extra seats. Army travels with so many. Delaware basketball, again, Corbin into the game. He's got in the corner. 10 seconds of shooting as he finds Harris, tracks it down near half court. Here's Holden, going to make something happen off the dribble. Hangs, uses his left, misses. Corbin crashes. The tip in, no good. Follow, no good from that. And a rebound by Travis Rollo for Army.
Corbin playing very aggressive on the boards. Might be better served coming down with the rebound, faking to get his body under control, and then scoring through outstretched arms.
Army with the score tied gets it to Larry Toomey on the left side. Now it goes back to Williams. Williams a couple dribbles. Toomey had the three open, didn't take it. 15 to shoot as Army works the ball around the perimeter. 14 minutes left in the first half. And they get in the hands of Dylan Cox. Cox lets it fly, missing, and a rebound by Chavarsky. Corbin, a good rebounder, averaging over 3.5 per game. It's back to Pinkert for Delaware's offense.
Delaware loves to push the ball early, and then if they don't have something this year, I really like their patience. Draw the ball back out, get it in Holden's hands, and start running the offense.
The offense has looked the best I've seen it so far tonight, running some set plays and really taking their time, like you said, on the offense. I agree. Sky Johnson in the post, gets it knocked away, back to Holden. 10 seconds to shoot for Corey Holden. Crossover. And an up-and-under move blocked from behind by good defender Dylan Cox. Ball on the floor with 3 seconds to shoot. And it gets in the hands of Army. Shot clock violation is going to be the call. Shot Army clock. Had the ball anyway after a scrum.
Delaware's trying to go inside out with Holden. Though Holden's expertise is more put the ball on the floor, shoot floaters, get the ball in transition, and use his body. They might be better served having Pickett or Hayes dump it in, because then if they help off, he'll be able to throw the ball back out, the post player that is, and get a wide open shot for someone who's a little bit more accustomed to shooting that shot from the relocate.
9-9 is the count. 13-11 first half. Kyle Wilson with the basketball. Gets it back to Cox with the foul line. Ferguson. Some starters back in the game for Army. One dribble Ferguson. Too strong in the lap with Sean Locke, who is on the DL for this game after he had a tough injury at the end of the Villanova game. We talked to him, though. He's all right.
And that turnover was created because Sky Johnson was very active on Ferguson at the post area. Great activity with his hands. Forced Ferguson to play faster than he wanted. The turnover ensued.
9-9, still the count. Harris on top, guarded by Ferguson. Mosley in the game at point guard for Corey Holden. He's got the basketball on the wing. Corbett on top now. Wilson defends. Picks up his dribble. 14 to shoot for Pinkert. Now it's Johnson on top. They work the ball around the perimeter. Now 10 to shoot for Mosley. Mosley around a couple defenders. Lost it on his hip. Gets it back. 5 to shoot, though, for Champ. Champ with 4. He's going to have to create. 3 seconds. Into the hands of Harris. Harris gets it off and misses everything from the left baseline. Good defensive set that time for the Army Black Knights.
Mosley, who is an explosive player, loves to get into the lane, but right now he's just got to learn against these bigger college players. He's more apt to pull the ball up inside the foul line and shoot it or distribute it. He gets in a little too deep, got himself in trouble there.
And he's got to know with under 4 seconds to shoot that pass to Barnett Harris, not one that he needs to be making. Kyle Wilson drives for Army, score tied at 9. Toomey, corner to Wilson. Pinkert has the duties of defending him. Back on top to Cox. Mosley, a good defender on Cox. And now it's in the corner. Ferguson tracks it down. Johnson all over him. 8 to shoot now for Army. It's Wilson. 6 to shoot for him. He drives. Fadeaway jumper is short. Long rebound in the hands of Sky Johnson, who hauled it in traffic.
That was a great defensive possession by Delaware, doing a great job of handling the quasi-Princeton offense. Pass cut fill with some screens. I love their activity on the defensive end tonight.
11:39 to go first half. Mosley, center circle. 5 second count underway as Cox is defending, but he passes it off to Pinkert. Pinkert dumps it down to Harris. Harris left block working on Ferguson. Into a double team, he spins, shot blocked, and back to Army it goes.
Ferguson had great position on the low block there to defend Barnett ahead of Harris as he turned to his right shoulder.
8th block by Ferguson, and Cox bailed out. He was not under control as he got into the paint, but the second foul against Delaware brings us to a timeout. 11:19 remaining, first half, 9-9 is the count for the Bob Carpenter Center.
Hey fans, 12 and younger, do you want to be a future Blue Hen? Join the Future Hens Club presented by St. Francis Healthcare for invites to exclusive events and free admission to select UD games.
Meet coaches and players like us.
Get your official Future Hens t-shirt and more surprises.
To join, log on bluehens.com with a parent, click on Fan Zone, then Kids Club. Click Register Here, fill out your information, and click Submit.
Join today!
I'm here because this is my home. Delaware Pride. You can say I have that. It's bigger now. The state is across my chest. Now it's about all of us. Now I am a Blue Hen. Experience it. I'm here.
How many down here? 400 down there.
Welcome back to the Bob Carpenter Center. And we are sitting finally at the Delaware broadcast table, brought to you by Value Days, Exxon, and Shell. Download the Dashian app by texting WDSD to 55123. You'll get weekly free item savings on all types of great food items, gas, drinks, and more. And all you have to do is text the message WDSD to 55123 for the Dashian app today. 9-9, still the count here. 11:19 remaining in the first half. We'll have free throws coming up for Dylan Cox as he was fouled by Anthony Mosley when we went to break.
What's interesting to me, here's a team that's averaging 80 points a game, and Delaware through the first almost 9 minutes have held them to 9 points, but also doing it without fouling. Only 2 team fouls so far. I like the foot speed of Delaware. They've done a good job of locating Wilson in transition and not allowing him to get any early shots, and they've done a good job defending their defensive glass.
Free throw missed by Dylan Cox. Both teams shooting 4 of 11 from the field so far. Well under the average for the Army Black Knights as they shoot 47% as a team. And right there, can't convert at the free throw line. Dylan Cox, a 60% free throw shooter, goes 0 of 2. And we're still tied at 9 as Mosley brings the ball up the floor for Delaware. Some pressure beyond the arc. Now between the circles, a pass to Hayes. Hayes dumps it down low to Jeffers, who is calling for the basketball. And a pass to Corbett. Somehow got through. Corbett lays it up and in for the right side.
A great job by Mo Jeffers locating that the help was coming underneath, and he found Corbett on the weak side. A great recognition and pass by Jeffers.
Ends in double digits first, but it doesn't take long for Army to find an answer. Ferguson off the window from straight away. We're tied at 11.
It was pretty good defense by Mo Jeffers on Ferguson. Or Ferguson with a nice jump hook in the middle of the lane using his length to score over top of Jeffers.
Ferguson 2 of 2. He had a double-double against Delaware at Army a season ago. Delaware won that basketball game. Now Mosley on the drive, hanging off the window with the kiss. Anthony Mosley knows a thing or two about winning on this floor. He won 2 state championships with Sanford.
Mosley has great body control and kind of snaked his way in and found a very creative way to score off the glass.
It was a good take for the freshman. 13-11 Delaware's lead. Almost halfway through the first half as Ferguson has it at the free throw line. Back to Mo Williams it goes. Williams, a senior, a rare senior on this team. A lot of juniors and sophomores as Morrison misses again. He's 0-for on the night on 4 attempts.
Eric Carter with a terrific closeout and contest there. I really like the activity, but all the freshmen kind of understanding the game plan and executing it quite well early on here in the first half.
Carter playing with some additional confidence since being added to that starting lineup. Hayes skip to Mosley on the right wing. 14 to shoot for Champ. Champ into the paint. Kick out. Corbett. Catch, shoot, 3. Good. Nice diss from Champ Mosley to find Chavarsky Corbett, who knocks down his 8th 3, and Delaware's up by 5, their largest lead.
What was even more impressive there, Scott, is he drove down the left side and located Corbett in the far right-hand corner.
Now a steal as it's knocked away by Maurice Jeffers. Ferguson going to be called on the reach trying to get the basketball back. That'll be the 3rd foul against Army.
I understand that Army likes to play fast in transition, but right now it seems to me that Delaware's dictating the pace of the game and Army playing almost too fast for their capabilities. Turn the ball over a couple times, unusual for a Zach Spiker coach team.
Corey Holden will check back in the game as Champ Mosley gets to the bench. High fives, butt pats from the coaching staff. They're very proud of the way he played, spelling Holden.
Very positive minutes there. If those two young freshman point guards play that well all season long, Delaware's going to be in great shape as this season gets further down the line.
16-11, Delaware with the lead early at home. Home opener for the Hens. 0-5 coming in against a 5-1 Army team. Now Pinkard inside. Good dish from Corbett, but a better block and defensive effort at the rim by Army. Now Scott Mammel into the game. He brings the ball down the floor. Finds his teammate Plum. Plum on the drive. And the shot missed by Travis Rollo inside the paint. Good dish to get him on the left block. He can't finish, but he was fouled. He'll shoot 2.
That last play was a wonderful cut by Pinkard coming down from the mid-post level to the left-hand low block. He's not used to scoring inside, and I think if he just learns to slow down and use a fake, the Army defenders are rotating quickly and are out of control, and they will leave their feet.
Pinkard, who we talked about shooting well from beyond the arc, now 10 of 28 on this season, over 40% the last 3. He's 2 of 19 inside the arc, though. So you mentioned not used to being close to the rim and getting those shots. He certainly has not been effective from inside the arc this season. Army not effective on the free throw line. It's 2 misses again from Rollo, but he gets his own rebound. No one boxed out the shooter, but he missed at the rim again. So Army no points on that possession.
Delaware were very fortunate there. Pinker was blocking out on the left-hand side and couldn't get his arms up in time to get the rebound. Good play by Kasman Hayes.
Inside, it's Jeffers spinning and scoring. Maurice Jeffers likes that spin move. You credit Jeff Rafferty for that.
Yes, he does. Coach Rafferty's done a great job with Maurice Jeffers. But what I loved about Jeffers is he's being much more aggressive, looking for his action down on the low post.
We saw that spin move a couple games back. He's effective on that block. We're going to need him for some additional offense this year. West Point works the ball around the perimeter, a 3-point shot, and again an offensive rebound as Pinkard boxed out but could get his arm out to grab the rebound. It was in his area. Kyle Wilson, deadly from 3, wide open, and he knocks it down.
Delaware is playing good defense. They've got to run down what we call those 50-50 balls. And once they hit the floor, you've got to have 2 or 3 Delaware players working towards it. Pinkard working very hard in his block out, got to get his hands up.
18-14, Delaware's lead. Inside to Jefford, ball poked away. A foul going to be called against Army. And with that, we'll take a timeout. 7:44 remaining in the first half. Delaware up by four. It's 18-14 on 94.7 WDSD.
Hello, Delaware fans. This is Coach Brock at beautiful Lums Pond State Park, just minutes from Delaware Stadium. I'm inviting you to come to the park, enjoy their year-round camping, boat rentals, equestrian center, and so much more. While you're here, experience the Go Ape Treetop Adventure. Go Ape is an outdoor experience where you can live life adventurously and experience the park from 50 feet up in the trees, hanging by a wire. To learn more about Go Ape or to book your visit to the course, visit www.goape.com. Go Hens!
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone. Cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Oh, 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 oh.
Welcome back to the Bob Carpenter Center. I want to get you a scoreboard update brought to you by Glasgow Medical Aid Units, making a difference one patient at a time over 60,000 times a year with locations in Glasgow, Christiana, and Middletown. Save time, save money, get well. Visit them at GlasgowMedicalCenter.com. A couple of games underway in the CAA. William & Mary, an early lead against Richmond. The Tribe 5-1 on the season thus far. They return CAA preseason player of the year, Marcus Thurton. They're up 15-14 in the first. Also in the first half, Harvard beating Northeastern right now, 22-10, 8 minutes left in the first. In that one, UNCW up 21-8 over St. Andrews, and Towson trails by one to Coppin State. Corbett throwing it up for grabs to Holden. Holden looking like a wide receiver catching that one with Maxwell Lennox not too far away. He'll bring it up the floor, though, and bring it to the left side. Now off the screen from Carter, brings it to the right, stops, and gives it to Pinkert, a long two, fading away, missing, rebounded by Army, and that's Kiefer Jordan who grabbed it for West Point. Now it's Lennox, backing down, holding, kicks it back out. Jordan with the basketball momentarily, finds Wilson. Wilson leads Army with 6 points in this one. Ends up 18-14. Jordan with the basketball, center right elbow. Looking for Tanner Plum. Plum with it now, 16 to shoot. He works it around the perimeter. Lennox on the right side in front of Delaware's bench. Down low to Jordan. Jordan kick out. They work it again around the arc. Looking for a backdoor cut, nothing there. Wilson going to have to create. Ball fake. Now a shot, fired and good. Third triple of the night for Kyle Wilson, and Delaware's up by one.
Pickard got caught on the ball screen. He's got to have help from the top side there. Carter's got to realize that much quicker. Come out and hedge, especially when it's Wilson involved.
And now on the other end, Hayes trying to bounce it to Corey Holden, but the Army defense was there, and another turnover for Delaware.
Army is known for their high-level pressure man-to-man. We saw some pressure at the full court, but at half court, they are very physical, and if it's not a closely called game, some of that physicality will create turnovers.
Cax with it. He's the point guard for Army, averaging over four assists per game. They get it to Wilson. Wilson, a threat to score anytime he's got the ball in his hands. Now Ferguson, 2-of-2 from the field, and 3-of-3 has used the baby hook from the right block to give Army the lead back. It's 19-18, 6-19 first half.
That's where a low post experience defensively would work. Ferguson was allowed to turn to his left shoulder. He's a right-hander. That's the move he loves. He's got to be forced to go into the middle with his left hand.
Now a steal by Cox and a foul on Delaware. Hens getting sloppy with the basketball these last two possessions. That's allowed West Point to get the lead back.
Empty possessions are the worst thing a young team can have. They've got to learn to value the ball. They've got to learn to play a little bit slower. Things were going well for them. Now they're out of rhythm. I wouldn't be surprised here at some point Coach Ross uses a timeout, if nothing else, just to calm his young team down.
It's the fourth foul on Delaware. First on Eric Carter after the turnover. And West Point will bring the ball up the floor with Dylan Cox on the left side. Works to the right, 28 to shoot. Inside, no look to Ferguson. Blocked by Harris at the rim. Barnett Harris checking in and sending the ball back out. It's Hens basketball.
Ferguson slipped the screen, but Barnett Harris was there from the weak side. A perfect opportunity to block the ball.
Hold it to Pinker. 22 to shoot for Delaware. Right wing. Holden gets it back. Calls for Hayes. Hayes with a jab step, trying to get it into Sky Johnson. Now a crossover. Wilson defends. Inside. Good move by Hayes. Slipped through two defenders and laid up using the right.
The best way to attack pressure man-to-man is to put the ball on the floor and get to the basket. Delaware doing a better job of that.
Hens up by one, 2019. Now a block by Barnett Harris. That's two in a row. Hens on the run. Hayes taking it into traffic. Loses it. Gets it back. And he'll slow things down.
The energy level that Barnett Harris can supply to a team is unbelievable. He's such a great young man, but what I love is he comes in and plays so hard, and once he gets his emotions under control, he's going to be an outstanding player.
16 to shoot for Delaware as Holden gets inside, uses the left, tucked angle, misses, reset shot clock on the offensive rebound. Sky Johnson doesn't need to use any of it as he puts it back up and through. Hens are up three. 22-19, under five to play, first half. Edwards with the basketball, loses it, and there's Harris again with the steal this time. Holding down the floor, rises to the rim, scores in transition, and the Hens force Army to call a timeout.
And that's all started by Barnett Harris. Two blocks, a steal. He was smart enough to give the ball to Holden, who went in very creatively from the right-hand side. He is a left-hander, worked his body in, was able to finish with his right. A very smart play by Barnett Harris there, and a great finish by Holden.
And Harris has been the spark for this team. We talked about in the pregame show that College of Charleston comeback that was sparked by his energy. What I love about Barnett Harris is he's not there offensively, but that does not stop him from seeing minutes or stop him from having the confidence and really knowing his role on this basketball team. He knows he's effective out there if he's providing energy, blocking shots, getting steals, and you see it on the last three possessions for Army. Harris was involved in all three.
It starts with the fact that Barnett Harris is a high quality and character young man. Then he's also very bright. You and I have had several conversations with him. Very impressive.
I can't keep up. You can.
About many things. But what I like about him here is he's learning to play within himself and do what he can do for the team at a very high level. Great energy here supplied by Barnett.
After the 32nd timeout taken by Zach Spiker, Army back on the floor. See what they design out of the timeout. And Plum with a ball fake, leans in from the left side, misses. Edwards with an offensive rebound, back up and through. Delaware going to have to do better on the offensive glass as an adjustment in the second half.
One of the worst things that can happen to a defensive rebounder is a short side miss, because typically you're inside them blocking out on the weak side. That ball came directly into the Army player's hands. He was able to lay it in.
Harris from the top of the key to the rim. Blocked, though. He was fouled. Barnett Harris said, "What's that about me not having an offensive game?" And almost brought this place to their feet.
What about the fact, though, that the young player is able to dribble with his right hand from the mid-post area and rise up for the dunk? His ball handling and overall offensive skills have really improved since last year.
He is electric, and we love Barnett Harris here at the Bob Carpenter Center. His foul, though, brings us to a timeout. 3:57 remaining in the first half. Hens up by three. Back in a moment on 94.7 WDSD.
The champion setting it off again. Oh, we on fire, we on fire. Running our campaign, doing the whole shebang. Oh, we on fire, we on fire. Get up, stand up, throw your hands up. Welcome to the other land of dreamers, brothers, sisters, others. Yeah, we on fire like that.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to BlueHens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
Welcome back to the Bob Carpenter Center. I want to remind our listeners that today's broadcast at 94.7 WDSD is powered by Brandywine Electronics. Visit BEL.com. 3:57 to play in the first half. Delaware's best half of the season, shooting 11 of 21, over 50% from the floor, 2 of 2 from beyond the arc. For Army, though, what's kept them in it, offense points off of turnovers and second chance points. 8 points off of turnovers, 7 second chance points.
And how about the fact that Delaware, who has not been shooting particularly well from the outside, has only taken 2 3-point shots and made them both, and they pounded the ball inside of the paint. They realized that's where their advantage is, 16-8 down in the low block, and that's a credit to the coaching staff for getting these young team to buy into the game plan.
Harris makes one of two. Second one a miss goes to Army. And now Williams will let it fly from the left side. Missing, but another offensive board, this time for Dylan Cox. And Army sends it back out to the right side. Edwards on the drive, lays it up around Pinkert, but a blocking foul to be called against his sophomore, Devon Pinkert. And that'll be the fifth on the Hens.
I thought Pinkert was actually very intelligent there as he saw the drive coming. He was inside the circle and decided to back off. I thought that was one they probably could have waved off. One of the problems with a team that shoots a lot of long-range threes, especially early in the clock, is that the rebound misses are going to be so far out that you've got to have everybody digging in and helping out. That time Mosley over-contested, ran by, and the rebound came back. That's where you need the players to all realize the ball is going to rebound probably 5 to 8 feet further out. You've got to have five sets of hands working in there.
First free throw good. Second as well from Edwards. Army now 3 of 8 from the free throw line. Mosley wants to push. The initial break not there, so we'll pull it back out as Delaware's done well in this first half. Corbett, couple drives. Corner, it's Hayes. Catch, shoot, three, off the mark. Sky Johnson has the ball tipped. Oh, I thought that was off of a West Point player. As Johnson was giving it all to try to grab the offensive rebound, it'll go to Army, though.
Now that was a great split and kick. Hayes caught it in rhythm. But I'm not sure at certain times early in the shot clock, maybe he passes that up and shot fakes and gets inside for a little bit better shot, especially if he's not in terrific rhythm.
Hayes, who averages over 16, only 2 points in the first half. Good slip and pass inside as Toomey's able to score and tie this one back up at 25 for Army.
Army's gone to a full court man-to-man. It's right here a little bit more harassment, but look for them to turn it up later on.
And that's an offensive foul as Mosley extended that left arm, and it was extended enough to get the whistle blown the second on the freshman from Sanford.
And that's what the pressure will do to you. If the officials allow a little bit of bumping, you've got to be able to play within yourself and not respond to that and just use your quickness or your ball handling skills to get by people.
That'll bring Pinkert back in. Pinkert, Corbett, Hayes, Holden, and Sky Johnson on the floor for Delaware. Toomey, Lennox, Edwards, Wilson, and Kiefer Jordan in the game for West Point.
Let's not forget that bad shots and offensive fouls are turnovers.
Here's Wilson, 3 of 3 from beyond the arc, gives it up to the point guard, Maxwell Lennox, the senior captain on this team. Jordan with the basketball, left elbow, 20 to shoot, dribble handoff to Wilson. Wilson, 3 of 4 today, dribbles through traffic, lost it, got it back, climbs to the three-point line, lets it fly, and he's 4 of 4, Kyle Wilson. Now we know why he's a player of the year candidate in the Patriot League.
He's a great spot-up shooter, gets every part of his body perfectly square to the basket. He's got a wonderful release with great spin. I really love this man. He plays at an extremely high level.
12 points already for Wilson, averages 21 on the season. He's got his team up by 3, 28-25, 2:16 remaining in the first half. Hens led by as many as 5. Here's Hayes. Trying to shake Wilson on the drive left. And he gets inside. Blocking foul going to be called against Army. That's his 6th against the Black Knights, but I believe Kaz was in the act of shooting. He should have 2 coming up.
And that's great recognition by Kazman Hayes. When Delaware made their run, they were successful for 2 reasons. They were driving the ball via the dribble versus the tough pressure man-to-man, and they were pounding the ball inside to their bigs. That was a good job by Hayes, recognizing he had an opportunity to turn the corner. He did it because he had lower shoulders than the defender, gets in and draws the foul.
Hayes at the free throw line, 73% free throw shooter this season, averaging 16.6 points per game coming into this basketball game. Kazman Hayes, as his first one's up and off the mark, had attempted 21 field goals in each of the last 2 games, making only 10 of 42. The first Blue Hens player since Devon Sadler opened up the season in 2011 to have 20 or more field goal attempts in 2 games in a row. Sadler had 48 to open up the 2011 season. But that's the kind of green light he has now on this team, at least until Kyle Anderson gets back shooting-wise. He's got that Devon Sadler type of green light. He makes 1 of 2, and it's 28-26, Army on top. Here's Cox, dribble drive, uses the left hand, gets inside, beautiful take by Dylan Cox, and Army is up by four. It's 30-26.
Delaware is hard hedging the high screen, meaning that the man guarding the screener is jumping out quite high. That time Ferguson slipped the screen, created some traffic in the middle of the lane, allowed Cox to get to the basket with his left hand and score.
Corbett on top to Jeffers, who just checked it. 20 is shoot for Delaware. Hold it. Whips it inside to Jeffers. He couldn't hold on, though. If he caught that, it could have been a dunk. Beautiful pass by Holden. Instead, it's a turnover. Wilson on the other end gets a three, and that is what happens when you leave Kyle Wilson open. He is 5 of 5 from downtown.
A team like Army and a player like Wilson are very dangerous in transition, especially if Delaware has their defenders on the wrong side of the court. Holden needed to recognize sooner that Wilson was there, even though it wasn't his man. He's got to acquire him and close out that shot.
Delaware needs to finish this last minute strong. They led by five. Now they trail by seven, their largest deficit of the first half. Hayes drives baseline, cut off, corner, Pinkert, and he stepped on the sideline, catching the pass from Holden, and another turnover for Delaware. They've got to take better care of the basketball because Army's making them pay on the other end.
One of the problems when you rely on three-point shooting, as you spot up now with the way the court's designed, if you're in the deep corner, you don't have much room there. And if a pass takes you slightly one side or the other, it's very easy to step out of bounds. Many times you're better off not spotting up at the three and getting yourself a little closer to the basket to enable the pass to be successful.
Army with a chance for a two-for-one here. Cox inside, Ferguson. Dylan Cox has made two great plays the last two possessions for Army. That time finding Ferguson for the layup. Shot clock unplugged, and a timeout can be taken by Monte Ross. Can't take it into the second half, so he's going to design a play for the last 31 seconds of this first half. The Hens, as I said, led by five, but Army has been able to find some answers offensively over the last 2 minutes or so.
They've worked the ball from the high post area, and then what I mean by slipping the screen, as the defender starts to rise out and challenge the dribbler, the screener doesn't stay in the screening position. He immediately rolls to the basket. That creates help rotation from the weak side much sooner than expected. If you don't double team the ball properly, and if you come off to try to recover, that allows the shooter to turn the corner, thus getting a better look. And what they've done is, instead of shooting, they've been driving the ball and then finding the man who has rolled early on wide open on the weak side. So Delaware's got to make an adjustment there, maybe change the way they're playing the high ball screen, but also, as you've already mentioned, take much better care of the basketball at the offensive end. Though a wonderful delivery by Holden to Jeffers, who just wasn't able to catch the pass, and it would have been a basket. So Delaware's got to slow down, not get frustrated, make sure they get a great shot here at the end of the half.
Delaware usually good coming off of timeouts and huddles. We'll see what Monte Ross drew up. 24 seconds left in the first half. Hens trail 35-26 on their home floor for the first time this season. Hens 0-5, Army 5-1. Holding deep left side with 10 seconds left. Here comes Jeffers to set the screen. Holding to the right side, six to shoot now. He pulls up, right elbow, jumper is smooth from the freshman Holden with 1 second left. West Point can't get a shot off, and Delaware will trail at the break, 35-28.
A great last possession. It started with Holden just dribbling the ball out near the timeline. Maurice Jeffers came with the screen. He avoided it to the right and then crossed back over, which he's very capable of, rising up into that mid-range shot. What I like about Holden is he understands that his game is better served off the dribble inside the three-point line than relying on long-range threes.
Some things to fix for Delaware in the second half, but overall a very good first half of basketball for the 0-5 Blue Hens. We're going to take a timeout. We come back energized. Delaware at the half, presented by the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local 313, and its local contractors. We'll send it back to the WDSD studios after this. Hens trail at the break.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone. 'Cause I'm gonna make this place yours.
up, throw your hands up. Welcome to the other land of dreamers, brothers, sisters, others. Yeah, we all fight like that.
Hey fans, 12 and younger. Do you want to be a future Blue Hen? Join the Future Hens Club presented by St. Francis Healthcare for invites to exclusive events and free admission to select UD games.
Meet coaches and players like us.
Get your official Future Hens t-shirt and more surprises.
To join, log on bluehens.com with a parent, click on Fan Zone, then Kids Club. Click Register Here, fill out your information, and click Submit.
Join today!
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the second edition of Beyond the Arc. I'm Scott Klaskin here with head coach Monte Ross. And coach, we come into this show after a season opening loss at Liberty, 61-55. A young team you put out there without a senior returning starter, Kyle Anderson. A bunch of guys either starting for the first time or playing for the first time. And you said after the game, you know, last season it was win or lose. I liked your quote saying this year it's win or learn, and a learning experience and some pretty good play from your group of youngsters.
No, you know what? I didn't know what to expect. Uh-huh. It was really a bit unnerving to go into the game. And then, you know, once the game got started, I thought they handled themselves very well. And then when we got down 9, I believe, with 8 minutes to go, I didn't know what to expect. I knew we were going to put them in certain positions and hopefully, but I was so proud of the way that they responded, because I thought it was going to, you know, our mental toughness was going to be tested on the road, get down 9 late in the game. Are you going to start feeling sorry for yourself? Are you going to start to second guess yourself? What will be your reaction? And their reaction was tremendous for them to make a run, take the lead, and that led me right there. That was like a watershed moment for me. Like, you know what? We're going to be all right. Right. We're going to be all right. You know, this was a night where we just didn't make shots, but the mental makeup will lead us to be okay.
Yeah, you mentioned not making shots. The opportunity was there, a little irony in a show called Beyond the Arc, and the team shoots 3 of 24 in the opener against Liberty. But you said even after the game, those shots are going to fall this season. Was it a little bit of nerves? Was it a mixture of Liberty's defense? Why do you think maybe the shots weren't falling against the Flames?
Early on, it was nerves. I think early on, absolutely, it was nerves. It was guys that hadn't really been in certain positions, and we were putting them in those positions. And then I thought in the second half, you know, not taking anything away from Liberty, because they're going to be a good ball club this year. They are a good ball club. But I thought we had some good looks, and the ball just didn't go in for us. So, again, it was important to me that we took a certain class of shot. And we took the class of shot that I wanted us to take. It was just a matter of, you know, one of those nights. The ball just didn't go in for us.
47 rebounds, 23 on the offensive glass. You got to be proud of the effort by committee that your big guys playing minutes or extended minutes for the first time were able to put forth.
No, absolutely. And that's one of the things that we're going to really harp on is, unfortunately, we might miss a lot of shots. So there are going to be a lot of offensive rebounding opportunities. But we've been really encouraging these guys to go to the glass every single time and really get some easy buckets for us and give us some extra possessions. And I thought they did an absolutely wonderful job of that last night.
By the time this episode of Beyond the Arc airs, you'll have played a couple of games, three games, in fact, in California. So let's talk about what's coming forward in the trip against Cal Poly, Cal State Bakersfield, and Stanford, your first opponent in that mix. Cal Poly, a familiar opponent. What do you expect against this round against the Cal Poly?
Well, again, there'll be a difficult matchup. They'll be home. We'll be on the road, obviously. We're going out a day early just to get the guys acclimated to the trip, to the time change, and the difficult travel. But, you know, Cal Poly, they're well coached. They're a team that, they like to run a system, and it's important for us to be really attentive to detail. And if we do that, I think, you know, we really increase our chances. But, again, it's going to be important for us to continue growing, continue learning, continue improving. And then I think, we'll get exactly what we want to get.
And an early bonding opportunity for a young team to be on the road on the West Coast. So for an extended period of time, I think you guys will be out there for a week total. And after Cal Poly, you'll take on Cal State Bakersfield. And then, of course, a top team in the country in Stanford. I'm sure you're looking forward to both those games as well.
Well, Bakersfield will allow us to hook up with an old nemesis, Rob Barnes, who was at Georgia State in the league. And it was funny when I called Rod about the game. He was like, man, you drove me out of the CAA with you guys winning all the games. Now you're going to come out here and drive me out of Bakersfield. So we had a good laugh and a good chuckle about that. But it'll be good to see Rod. I saw him on the recruiting circuit this summer and opportunity to see him. And then, going on to Stanford and playing them, in terms of athletic programs, the totality of it, the best in the country. Mm-hmm. So it'll be great for our guys to get out there and see the facilities, see the atmosphere out there, and I'm looking forward to it.
All right, well, we wish you the best of luck, and now we're going to do something that's never been done on Beyond the Arc before, and that's look into the future. So we are going to toss it now to highlights from what you guys did in California.
It's an amazing thing.
When we come back on Hens All Access.
Hello, Delaware fans. This is Coach Brock at beautiful Lums Pond State Park, just minutes from Delaware Stadium. I'm inviting you to come to the park, enjoy their year-round camping, boat rentals, equestrian center, and so much more. While you're here, experience the Go Ape Treetop Adventure. Go Ape is an outdoor experience where you can live life adventurously and experience the park from 50 feet up in the trees, hanging by a wire. To learn more about Go Ape or to book your visit to the course, visit www.goape.com. Go Hens!
Welcome back to Beyond the Arc. Now let's take a look at how the Hens fared during their trip to California. First up was a contest against the Mustangs of Cal Poly, who closed the first half with a dominating run and opened a huge halftime lead on the way to defeating the Hens 78-60. Kasman Hayes paced Delaware with a career-high 22 points as he knocked down three early three-pointers, finished 9 of 10 from the foul line. Freshman point guard Corey Holden reached double figures for the second consecutive game with 12 points, while Shavarsky Corbin added 9 points on 3 long-range three-pointers. Barnett Harris also grabbed 6 boards as he led the Hens with rebounds for the second straight game. Next, the Hens traveled to Bakersfield to take on the Roadrunners, and field goal shooting once again was an issue as the Hens connected on just 12 shots from the field on the way to a 70-52 non-conference loss against CSU Bakersfield. Delaware shot 26.7% from the field, hit only 5 field goals during the second half, and fell to 0-3 on the year. Sophomore Devon Pinkard paced the Blue Hens with 14 points and a career-high 10 rebounds. That's his first career double-double, while classmate Kasman Hayes added 12 points. Those were all in the first half. Corey Holden reached double figures for the third consecutive game. He scored 10, took along with 4 assists, while fellow rookie Shavarsky Corbett contributed 8 points and 6 boards. Delaware did connect on 21 of 32 free throws, but could not overcome its third consecutive shooting performance below 32%. The final game of the California road trip came at historic Maples Pavilion against the Stanford Cardinal. Stanford jumped out to an early double-figure lead, as teams who receive votes do, and they never seriously were threatened from there on the way to an 84-47 win over Delaware. Stanford is receiving votes in the top 25 polls. They're 4-1 on the season. Their only loss was to fourth-ranked Duke. The Blue Hens again featured a young rotation. 5 freshmen and 4 sophomores played. They dropped to 0-4 on the season. Kasman Hayes paced the Hens once again, 15 points from him. He reached double figures for the 4th consecutive game to start the season, although the sophomore finished just 4 of 21 from the field. Shavarsky Corbett added a season-high 10 points off the bench, and fellow rookie Corey Holden added 8 points, 6 rebounds, and 5 assists for the young point guard. Delaware will face another stiff challenge this Sunday. The Hens will take on 12th-ranked Villanova at the Wells Fargo Center in Philly. Game begins at 4:30 and will be televised on Fox Sports 1. When we come back, Matt Janis sits down with head coach Tina Martin to catch up on how her squad is doing just 4 games in the season, right here on Beyond the Arc.
Rush hour or relax hour? It's your choice. Dark. Moving forward.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to BlueHens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
Hello, Delaware fans. This is Coach Brock at beautiful Lums Pond State Park, just minutes from Delaware Stadium. I'm inviting you to come to the park, enjoy their year-round camping, boat rentals, equestrian center, and so much more. While you're here, experience the Go Ape Treetop Adventure. Go Ape is an outdoor experience where you can live life adventurously and experience the park from 50 feet up in the trees, hanging by a wire. To learn more about Go Ape or to book your visit to the course, visit www.goape.com. Go Hens!
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
We are the champions, setting it off again. Oh, we on fire, we on fire. Running our own campaign, doing the whole shebang. Oh, we on fire, we on fire. Get up, stand up, throw your hands up. Welcome to the other land of dreamers. Brothers, sisters, others, yeah, we all fight like that.
I'm here because this is my home. Delaware pride. You can say I have that. It's bigger now. The state is across my chest. Now it's about all of us. Now I am a Blue Hen. Experience it.
Handled it well, and there's some skill there. It's just got to come out, you know, with some time.
We'll finish it in the second half. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks.
Appreciate it.
Good job, Phil. Good luck.
That was assistant coach Phil Martelli, Jr. Always doing a good job of scouting. We haven't been able to talk to Phil this season yet, but he always does a great job with the scout. A busy scout job for Coach Martelli, as there's like 28 guys that are going to play tonight. He had to know all of them. 12 guys Army played in the first half, and I'll tell you how they did quickly with the REMAX first half stats, brought to you by REMAX. Nobody sells more real estate than REMAX. Outstanding agents, outstanding results. And Kyle Wilson, the player that we talked about in the open, leading everyone and scoring 15 points. He's 5 of 5 from three-point range, not too far behind Kevin Ferguson with 8 points. He leads the team with 3 rebounds. Leading assist man is Dylan Cox for Army. Army shooting 48% from the field, 46% from 3, and just 3 of 8 from the free throw line. Delaware, led by Corey Holden, who made that final shot of the first half. He's got 8 points, 5 for Shavarsky Corbett, 3 points for Pinkard and Hayes, 2 points apiece for Johnson, Mosley, Jefferson, Carter, and a point for Barnett. Harris, Delaware shooting 52% from the floor, 67% from 3, just 2 of 6 from the free throw line, and Army gets the basketball first as we start the second half of action.
It's very important that Delaware locates Wilson, runs him off the three, and does a little bit better job inside on Kevin Ferguson. Make him turn into the middle with his left hand.
Hayes has the duty of guarding Wilson early in this second half as he gets the dribble handoff and spins, fires a deep two, missing, and a long rebound, almost tracked down by Army. Would have been their sixth offensive rebound instead into the hands of Mo Jeffords.
One thing Delaware, I know, talked about at halftime in the locker room, do a much better job of getting 5 people to those long rebounds.
Banker with one dribble and bounce pass to Eric Carter, who you heard Phil Martelli give praise to for his play in the first half. Pinkert in traffic, bounces it off. Jeffers, jump shot from 10, short on the baseline, and rebounded by Army.
I like the pass from Pinkert, giving up a forced shot to find his teammate Jeffers wide open along the baseline.
If Jeffers can develop that shot, it'll be a positive for the Blue Hens. Not there right now for Mo and his redshirt sophomore campaign. 3-point jump shot on the way from Army, off the mark, as Army starts off the second half 0 of 2 with a 35-28 lead. Corner, it's Pinkard in front of the Delaware bench. Delaware going right to left in this second half of action. And he gets to Jeffers again on the left block. Spinning on Ferguson. Baseline jam. Mo Jeffers rises to the rim.
That time, Jeffers felt the pressure high on his left shoulder. He spins, which he loves to do from that side. Drops in for the dunk. That was a great offensive move by Mo Jeffers.
Here's Ferguson with an answer on the block right side with that right hand. And he makes it 37-30. Army on top. Mo Jeffers, that's the second time we've seen him spin off that left block, and he's looked good doing it.
He's spinning to his right shoulder. Conversely, down at the other end, he's got to do a better job of defending against Ferguson, force him into his right shoulder, which is opposite of where Ferguson wants to go.
Yeah, Ferguson now 5 of 6 from the field. Corey Holden with the jump shot. And he's now 5 of 7. He's having quite the night.
Holden rose up there again over a shorter defender, but rejected the ball screen and found himself wide open.
He's hot. He's in double figures. First Blue Hen to get there. Ferguson, couple pump fakes. He misses strong straight away. A rebound by Eric Carter. Now Holden looking like he wants to push. Doesn't have numbers. He'll wait for some teammates. Down 37-32 here in the second half. Bounce pass inside to Jeffers. Jeffers into the paint. Jump shot. Good. Mo Jeffers calling for the basketball and scoring. He's got 4 in the second half. Hens down 3.
Jeffers feeling much more confident. Holden realizing that, as a smart point guard does, dumps it into him right on the block that he wanted it.
Third assist for Corey Holden. He leads the team with 4 per game. That's third best in the CAA. 7-10, second half. Cox stopped by Holden on the dribble drive. Pass to Toomey. One dribble and a handoff to Plum. Plum back to Toomey baseline. Corner, kick out 3, Cox around and out. Jeffers boxes out Ferguson. Ferguson reaches over him to grab the basketball and is called for the foul. That's going to be the second on Kevin Ferguson, the first on the Army Black Knights.
Mo Jeffers did a great job there of locating where Ferguson was. Ferguson is one of these post players that will consistently work for position, even though he might be able to post up. He's always looking for that offensive rebound position. Jeffers did a great job of getting his body on him. That enabled the foul over the back, and that's what Jeffers is doing, showing to me some of his best play of his career here this evening.
I agree with you. Inbound pass goes to Hayes. Full court pressure down the floor. Sky Johnson to the rim. Shot blocked. Late whistle as Luke Morrison blocked the shot but got him with the body. It'll send Sky Johnson to the free throw line where he shoots just 43% on the season.
Hayes recognized that they had a 2-on-1 opportunity. He gave the ball up early on, which was smart because the defender was removed from Sky Johnson. Johnson went in for the dunk, but he might be better off working to the backside using the rim as a shot block defender, but also faking, because if he gets these Army guys up when they are trying to block shots, he can have an and one, or at least make sure he gets to the line without a block.
Johnson misses the first, rattles in the second. Johnson, good minutes against Villanova, especially at the end. Had 4 points, 4 rebounds, and a steal against the Wildcats. And his second free throw makes it a one-possession game, 37-35. Army on top, 3.5 minutes in to this second half. It's Kyle Wilson, hesitation dribble, using the left. Back to Morrison. Morrison on the wing. He finds Wilson, who's 5 of 5 from downtown. Lazy pass, stolen away by Johnson. Johnson ahead of the pack. Sky's to the rim, but he's fouled. And he'll go back to the free throw line. We've had some almost highlights tonight as Harris and Johnson have both been fouled in dunk attempts.
Army loves to use elbow post players, and they many times get a little careless and just drop the ball off. That time Sky Johnson recognized where the passer was going to deliver the ball, cheated that side, and made a great push steal. Did a good job of trying to finish at the other end. So far, Delaware's defense, reminiscent of how they played in the first 16 minutes, really set the tone. And they're not panicking. They were down by 7. They're not trying to rush back, but they're letting their defense, which we saw a lot last season, bring them back into this game.
Johnson's first free throw is good. And how about that? A young team not panicking, and that's important in the second half as Johnson makes the second.
And that's what a veteran coaching staff will tell their team at halftime.
Don't get it all back in one possession. Backdoor and Ferguson blocked at, excuse me, that's Edwards blocked at the rim, but a foul's going to be called against Sky Johnson. It'll send Edwards back to the free throw line, where in the first half he shot 3 of 4.
Army overloaded the court on the left-hand side, had 4 of their players over there, and then brought down the extra man to the weak side. Harris got backdoor, but there was no help. Johnson rotated late, and that's why he got the foul.
First foul on Delaware. And some discussion on who the foul was on, as the officiating crew will go look at the monitor. It allows both teams to get back into their respective huddles. Kennedy Edwards playing for the first time this season for Army. Was the only player to make free throws in the first half. He was 3 of 4. The team as a whole shot 3 of 8. Joking with Coach Martelli at halftime off mic and saying, were you prepared for all 20 guys that this team dressed? And he wasn't even sure about Kennedy Edwards, because out of all the guys that travel, there are literally 20 guys on this team at least. He had not played yet this season. Making the most of his first game out there, though.
It's quite a task for these assistants who literally spend almost all of their free time, if they're not coaching and recruiting, and preparing for their next scout. This was Coach Martelli's, obviously. They divide up the schedule usually throughout the season, about a third and a third between Coach Rafferty, Coach Cheeks, and Coach Martelli. And occasionally someone might get a team that they know a little bit better, so you might have two scouts in a row. These guys will watch at least 5 game films to develop a scouting report. Then they spend the bulk of their time processing that information, trying to get it out to the players in a format that the players can use. You can't go through every team sets and every player, but you try to at least highlight their favorite things and also the keys to victory and who you have to defend. And I think Coach Martelli and the others have done a wonderful job in the year and a half that I've observed them getting the team ready to play.
They always do. And Delaware in the second half came out of the locker room certainly ready to play. A 9-2 advantage thus far in the second half. And Edwards makes the second free throw after missing the first. Army just 4 of 10 tonight from the free throw line thus far. A team that shoots 68% from the stripe on the season. Hens down by one, 38-37. Trying to get that first win of the season. 0-5 so far are the Hens. This is the first time they've played in Newark. Here's Holden to the rim. Fouled. Good on the layup, but they're going to wave it off. They're going to say continuation. And the foul was on the floor against Maxwell Lennox, who didn't have the speed to stay with the freshman.
Maxwell Lennox is thought to be the best on-the-ball defender in the entire program at the U.S. Military Academy, but Holden has done a great job of finding openings to utilize different types of his dribble to attack the basket against a very capable defender.
After the foul, the fourth foul on Army, it goes back to Holden. Off the inbound from Pinkert. Pinkert gets it back, 23 to shoot, reset shot clock for Delaware after the foul. In the corner to Hayes. Inside to Sky Johnson. Double team comes to Hayes. Extra pass from Harrison. Hayes lets it fly from three, and his first triple of the night is down. Delaware retakes the lead.
Delaware high-low. Johnson to Harris. Kicks it out to Hayes, who was in rhythm on the right-hand side.
Now a foul away from the ball as Pinkert was holding on to Kennedy Edwards trying to get open. That foul will bring us to a timeout, but Delaware coming out strong to start half number two. They've got the lead back in their hands. It's 40-38, 15-34 to play.
Hey fans, 12 and younger, do you want to be a future Blue Hen? Join the Future Hens Club presented by St. Francis Healthcare for invites to exclusive events and free admission to select UD games.
Meet coaches and players like us.
Get your official Future Hens t-shirt and more surprises.
To join, log on bluehens.com with a parent, click on Fan Zone, then Kids Club. Click Register Here, fill out your information, and click Submit.
Join today!
I'm here because this is my home. Delaware Pride. You can say I have that. It's bigger now. The state is across my chest. Now it's about all of us. Now I am a Blue Hen. Experience it.
Welcome back to the Bob Carpenter Center from the Value Days broadcast day. We're presented by Exxon and Shell. The score is Delaware 40, Army 38. The Hens trying to get their first win of the season, 0-5 coming in. Army ended the first half on a 14-3 run. Delaware starts the second half on a 12-3 run.
Delaware's taking better care of the basketball. They're also getting better shots. They're going inside and not always scoring, but going inside draws the defense in. Then you can kick it back out. The high-low there from Barnett Harris to Kasman Hayes in the corner. Very reminiscent of stuff we saw last year. But what I like about Delaware is they came out, they didn't panic. Their energy defensively has been outstanding.
Army with the basketball after the foul called against Devon Pinkert sent us to break. That was the second foul on Pinkert, second on Delaware. Now driving inside is Wilson through the trees and scoring. First time inside the arc. He's got a bucket, but he earned that one.
Wilson finds a lot of different ways to score. He can do it off the bounce. He can do it from the spot. And that time he took it all the way to the basket. Delaware's got to do a better job of helping Kasman Hayes when Wilson puts the ball on the floor.
Now it's Hayes' turn as Wilson defends him one-on-one. Hayes made a three last possession. Brings the ball to the right side. He drives inside, falling away. A foul going to be called, I believe, against Mo Williams, who came over to help. The senior's first foul, and the fourth now on Army.
Delaware's had most of their success when they've driven the ball against this physical defense. Army also likes to blitz hedge the high ball screen, but they're a little slower to recover, especially from the weak side, and I think Hayes and Holden have both exploited that.
Hayes back to the free throw line, where he's one of two tonight. Makes the first. Check that. That was the fifth foul on Army. Lead back to the Blue Hens. 14:53 remaining. Hayes, who made a three-pointer on last possession. Multiple three-pointers each game this season. He's got seven three-pointers made coming into today's game over the last two games. He makes both free throws. Heads up to 42-40. Ferguson with a basketball. Dribble handoff to Wilson. Now it's Holden guarding Wilson. Inside to Ferguson. Harris doing a good job on him on the right block. He brings it to the left side. Kick out to Williams. Williams, ball fake, 19 to shoot. Back to Ferguson, right elbow. Looking for a teammate. Now puts on the floor with a couple dribbles. Hands off to Wilson. Holding right there on him. Wilson driving. Loses grip. It was Corbett's long arms that knocked it away. Hens have numbers. Corbett, elbow jump shot is good, but he traveled before he got it off. Lost grip of the basketball. Took that stutter step and gave it back to Army.
Corbett did a great job of hedging in from the outside to block Kyle Wilson's drive on the last possession. Then just a little hurried there to come down. Barnett Harris also doing a great job defensively inside on Ferguson.
14-14 remaining. Second half inside Ferguson, this time on the left block. Harris defends a little too much with the body. And that'll be a foul against Harris, the third on Delaware.
And I would actually recommend when Ferguson gets the ball down low, drop off of him. He was looking for where your body is positioned on him. That way he can then turn to either shoulder. Barnett Harris did a great job on the play before of forcing Ferguson into his right shoulder. That was a good scouting report change by Coach Martelli.
First foul on Harris. And now it's almost a turnover. Johnny on the spot as that ball sailed over a few Delaware defenders into the arms of Kennedy Edwards as Cox left his feet without knowing what he's going to do with the basketball. You teach players not to ever do that. He made that mistake and got away with it. And now Edwards at the free throw line as a foul was called against Delaware reaching in.
And unfortunately, Devon Pinkert on the weak side kind of violated one of the cardinal sins of man-to-man defense, and that is always see the ball. He had his head turned. He would have been able to actually intercept that pass had he seen that, but that unfortunately enabled Edwards to get inside position on the what I would call the air ball pass by Cox.
Now Pinkert, though, most importantly, as Edwards makes the free throws, playing with three fouls now. 14:03 remaining, line of basketball left. Holden goes to the bench, not Pinkert, and Mosley checks in. Mosley had a good two-minute, three-minute spurt in the first half where he scored a tough bucket and had an assist to Javarski Corbett. Corbett catches it on top, thought about the three straight away, didn't take it. Now Hayes will, with Wilson in his face, that's an air ball, and Wilson did not deflect it, so it'll stay, or it'll go back to Army.
Even though Wilson was very physical there and the Delaware staff's looking for a foul, Hayes has got to understand, he's very closely guarded there. Shot fake and go by them like he did on the possession before is going to yield him much better benefits.
Hayes been able to get to the free throw line in this basketball game a couple times. Tie score at 42, 6.5 into the second half. On top, Army working the ball to their point guard, Cox. Cox to Edwards. Edwards squares, fires, hits. Why has this kid not played yet for Army? Wasn't in the scouting report, wasn't on my chart, but he is making his name known tonight. And Army up by three.
Well, Zach Spiker certainly knew what he could do for him. He has played him a lot of minutes. He's provided them with some great energy off the bench, but also very opportunistic shooter.
Jeffers drives, kicks out to Corbett. Corbett inside the paint, floats it using the left. Not enough, though. Ball comes loose. Jeffers with an offensive rebound. Kick out, Mosley. Mosley hesitates, now drives, and the lefty too strong. Tipped in by Big Mo on the inside. Check that. That was Javarski Corbett with the putback. And now a turnover as Mosley pressured the inbounder, and it was thrown out of bounds into the Delaware bench. The Hens get the ball back.
The prior play, though, was made by Maurice Jeffers with an unbelievably difficult and tough-minded rebound, offensive rebound inside, kicking it out, and then allowing the shot to occur. But that was a big-time offensive rebound by Mo Jeffers.
Now it's Mosley with the basketball after the turnover. Forced on the inbound pass. Champ with it. Pass to Corbett and too wide for Chavarsky Corbett. And Mosley this season, what's hurt him is the turnover. That's his eighth turnover of the season. Only two assists to go along with those eight turnovers.
It's inexperience, and he's throwing a pass almost across the court to Corbett, who he probably hasn't played a lot with, and they don't have that timing. But also, he's got to throw the ball away from the defense, not towards it.
Hens down by one. Can't take advantage of the turnover by Army. 45-44 is the count. Black Knights on top. Army, on the other hand, has taken advantage of Delaware's turnovers. They got 16 points off turnovers. Wilson on the kickout. Lets another three fly. His first miss. And it's saved for going out of bounds into Edwards. Edwards in the corner. Sends it back to Wilson. Wilson spins on top to Cox. Shot blocked by Corbett. But Edwards is there. His shot blocked by Jeffers. But Ferguson is there. And Ferguson, on the third chance for Army, gets it up and through.
That was a big-time hustle play there by Edwards. Two different possessions throughout that entire event down there. And then the long arms of Kevin Ferguson, who always seems to be in good position around the basket.
Sixth block of the season for Corbett. Leads the team in that category. Jeffers to Mosley, left side. Hens trail by three. Corbett calling for it. Catch, shoot. Fading away, missing off left, and a rebound by Toomey. Cox wants to push for the Black Knights. A crossover on the left side as Corbett slows him up. Back to Toomey. Right side, it's Wilson. Inside to Ferguson. Entry pass deflected by Mosley. Left open, though, is Edwards as Ferguson got it back. The assist and the basket. And Delaware might need to call a timeout. They do. A timeout taken by head coach Monte Ross. We'll take a break with him. 49-44 is the count. Army on top.
Hello, Delaware fans. This is Coach Brock at beautiful Lums Pond State Park, just minutes from Delaware Stadium. I'm inviting you to come to the park, enjoy their year-round camping, boat rentals, equestrian center, and so much more. While you're here, experience the Go Ape Treetop Adventure. Go Ape is an outdoor experience where you can live life adventurously and experience the park from 50 feet up in the trees, hanging by a wire. To learn more about Go Ape or to book your visit to the course, visit www.goape.com. Go Hens!
Hold on to me as we go. Just know you're not alone. 'Cause I'm gonna make this place yours.
Welcome back to the Bob Carpenter Center. I want to remind our listeners that Slam Dunk to the Beach is back. The nation's premier high school basketball showcase returns to Lewis, Delaware on December 27th, 28th, and 29th at Cape Henlopen High School. The same tournament that brought you LeBron James, Carmelo Anthony, and Kevin Durant will now feature the future of college and NBA hoops before they are stars. Tickets for single game and three-day passes are available right now at SlamDunkToTheBeach.com. Champ Mosley's alma mater, Sanford, will be there. Very exciting for the first state to have that tournament back.
I'm really glad to hear that you had been involved in that, had something to do with kind of working through all the public relations. They've got a great cast of teams going down there. I'm hoping to get down to see some of them, if not get some scouts in.
Back here in action off the timeout by head coach Monte Ross. Next whistle will also be a timeout for both teams. At the media break, 11:08 remaining. Delaware trails it by five. Hold it. Sees a hole. Drives. Passes out. It's deflected. Out of bounds it goes, and both teams will head back to their benches. We'll take another timeout. 11:01 remaining. Delaware trails 49-44 against the Army Black Knights.
We are the champions, setting it off again. Oh, we on fire. We on fire. Running our own campaign, doing the whole shebang. Oh, we on fire. We on fire. Get up, stand up, throw your hands up. Welcome to the other land of dreamers, brothers, sisters, others. Yeah, we all fight like that.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop,
Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to BlueHens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
Back here at the Bob Carpenter Center, I'm Scott Klatskin with Bill Harmon. Home opener for the Hens, 0-5 on the season, trying to get win number one against a 5-1 Army squad. And right now, Delaware, 10 turnovers, but Army maximizing efficiency off those turnovers. They've got 20 points off those 10 Delaware turnovers.
They really can't do much better than that, and it's so incumbent on Delaware to really value the ball, take care of it, don't force the issue. They've run some pretty good offense here. They need to just get a good shot every time and then attack the offensive glass.
Off the inbound, it's Pinker with the basketball. Hens trail 49-44. 16 to shoot, coming off the timeout for Holden. Deep left side, good defense by Lennox. Holden shakes it momentarily at the foul, and hesitation inside, leaves it for Jeffers. Jeffers can't grip it, but he's fouled on his way up, and he'll head to the free throw line where he shoots 57%. Love the pass from Corey Holden.
Very intelligent play by Holden. He drew the shot blocker, Ferguson, to him and then dropped the ball off to Jeffers, who's now kind of learning how to play with Holden. Holden can get anywhere he wants on the court, which is very important. He's got to learn that he isn't going to always be able to finish over the taller shot blockers, but if he gets his big men available, which Jeffers did there, he's going to have a lot of success and sets up other players, as we heard Coach Ross mention. He's a pass-first point guard.
Fouls on Maxwell Lennox, his third, so he'll check out. Six on Army. Jeffers makes the first free throw. Jeffers didn't score against Villanova, but had three rebounds and a block shot. Played just 4 minutes last season against Army. Second shot is short, and it's rebounded by Army. Kind of a flat shot that Jeffers has from the free throw line.
As Mo continues to work on his game, Mo Jeffers, he's going to learn he's got to get his elbow a little bit higher and get better rotation on the ball. Just too flat a shot.
49-45. Army's lead is four as Cox on the dribble drive goes back door to Wilson. Wilson loses grip, stolen away by Corey Holden. He wants to push across half court, slows up, waits for his teammates. Now a crossover on Cox. Into the paint he goes, hanging and drawing the foul. Corey Holden has that look in his eye that says, no one can stop me from getting where I want to be on the court. He'll shoot two.
He certainly can get anywhere he wants, especially going to his left. I would recommend that Army probably realizes that and overplays him, sends him to his right hand. And that time Holden, I think, was very fortunate there. He got bailed out by the foul. They had a tall shot blocker coming to challenge the shot. Holden took it a little too deep. I like it when Holden dribbles through, kind of like Steve Nash used to do, and then can almost retrace his steps and find one of the bigs available.
Holden's first free throw died on the back rim, fell through. Counts the same way. Second shot missing, tipped by Hayes, rebounded on the offensive glass by Mo Jeffers, and back to Holden it goes with Delaware down by three.
Mo Jeffers continues to make good decisions with the basketball, not forcing the issue there, getting it back out to Holden to run some more offense.
Corbett inside to Jeffers, foul away from the ball as it was Toomey and Holden tangled up. And that'll be a 1-1 for Delaware as that's the eighth foul against Army. Hens only have four, so any more fouls for Army the rest of the way send Delaware to the line.
Army loves to position themselves between the man they're guarding and the ball screen and sometimes cheat over it. And that can create Delaware to go backdoor or rub much higher than they want to go. But that time, I believe it was Holden kept coming over the top, created some interference and a good call by the officials. Army relies on a much more loosely called game. They want to be physical. They want to put their hands on you because they're not as quick as Delaware. And so their lack of foot speed is beginning here to show itself, especially when Holden and Mosley, we've seen, have been able to get almost anywhere they want on the court, especially to the basket.
Holden, front end the 1-1, good for Corey Holden, adding to his double-digit scoring effort. He's got 12 now. Holden, team's third leading scorer at just over 10 points per contest, second leading rebounder, leads the team in assists. He's having a heck of a start to his freshman campaign. But he misses a second. Jeffers goes over Ferguson to tip the rebound. Can't haul it in, though. And back to Army it goes. It's Cox with it on the right side. Under 10 to play in the ball game. Ferguson, right block, working hard on Jeffers. Passes to Cox. Cox runs into Jeffers and Carter. Might have gotten away with a traveling violation, but instead, he'll shoot two shots.
The Delaware staff is calling for a walk, and they are clearly right. Cox had switched his pivot feet. Very fortunate there to get bailed out. Good defense down on the low block by Mo Jeffers again on Kevin Ferguson. Ferguson, if he can't turn to his left shoulder, really doesn't know what to do with the basketball. Has not developed a left-hand jump hook, and I think Delaware's bigs have done a good job of changing up their game plan versus Ferguson here.
Army's first free throw good, just 7 of 13 from the stripe after that make. Mo Williams will check back in. Toomey to the bench. Cock to the free throw line. That was the first foul on Maurice Jeffers. Fifth on Delaware. Cox makes them both, and it's 51-47. Army on top, holding with the basketball down the right sideline after the make.
Army showing a little bit of pressure there. Look for them at some point to turn that pressure back up, which created a couple of Delaware turnovers.
Holding inside, kick out. Corbett, open three. Good! Freshman-to-freshman connection, and the Hens down just one.
That was Steve Nash there, dribbling through the defense and finding Corbett wide open in the corner, and I love how Corbett takes his time and squares himself.
Foul on the other end, Corbett being calling for the reach on Kyle Wilson. Ball on the floor when the foul was called. Six on Delaware, no free throws. But the next foul for Delaware will send Army to the stripe for a 1-on-1. Inbound left side. Ball deflected, gets in the hands of Ferguson. One dribble and a pass for the point guard. Cox on the left wing. Jeffers comes ahead. Now it's Ferguson with a dribble. Trying to get Wilson involved in the offense. Good defense by Hayes to deny. 20 on the shot clock. It's Ferguson left elbow this time. Here's Wilson. He doesn't need much room. Had some room. Didn't shoot it. And now it's Ferguson inside. Good D by Jeffers. Jeffers is there. Ferguson working hard. Bad angle. Missing. And Jeffers, what an effort, grabs the rebound.
You described it perfectly. Bad angle. But also the fact that Ferguson loves a ball fake, a head fake. Jeffers stayed down on his feet. Affected the shot. That's what forced it over the top of the basket. Great defense by Jeffers.
And the chance to take a lead here in the second half. Holden nearly pickpocketed as he went behind the back. Ball came loose. Carter was there to grab it for Delaware. Here's Holden with 13 to shoot between the circles. Inside the arc now. Into the paint. Holden using some patience and drawing the foul again. Corey Holden doing what he wants out there. And he's getting to the free throw line.
Well, he's got a matchup that he can exploit. He's taking the defender off the high ball screen. They are hard hedging it, sending him up about 30 feet away from the basket, but Holden is very explosive with the ball. He then gets back in on the correct angle and attacks the basket. At times, he may get a little too deep, but I think right now Coach Ross is letting him go. He's creating a lot of offense for his teammates, and if he can start making some of these foul shots, he was a 69% free throw shooter coming into the game. That's going to be very important down the stretch because he has the ball in his hands a lot.
And that's the ninth foul against Army as Holden misses the first free throw. So two free throws the rest of the way for Delaware with 8:34 to play. Still a lot of basketball to be played here at the Bob Carpenter Center. Hands down 51-50. Holden can tie it up with his second attempt, and he does just that. 51 apiece as Holden will get a breather. Mosley into the game. For Delaware, it's Harris, Hayes, Corbett, Carter, and Mosley on the floor for Delaware.
Mosley's going to show a little pressure here on Cox. Really, again, a harassment-type pressure, just enough to try to speed Army up just a little bit.
Cox gets it across half court, 27 to shoot, and brings it to the right side. Plum thought about the jumper, instead drives, shot, stops baseline. Back to Edwards, and they'll find Wilson between the circles. Left elbow, it's Jordan, who's in for Ferguson, who picked up his third foul. Wilson gets the handoff, 13 to shoot for him. He's looking to create. Gets it to Edwards. Edwards drives, left elbow jump shot is strong. Back iron, no, that's a push-off from Dylan Cox on Anthony Mosley. And now Mosley can walk up the floor, and it'll be a two-shot foul, as that's number 10 against West Point.
Eric Carter did a wonderful job there of challenging the shot as he got switched off onto Kennedy Edwards. He did a great job of rotating, challenging the shot without fouling, and then created the bad shot opportunity. I think Delaware's defense by their young players has been exceptional here, and that to me is a coaching staff that even though they're 0-5, has continued to work very hard on their fundamentals. Their energy has been excellent tonight, and that's just not because they're home. I think this is a team that's just getting more confident.
Anthony Mosley at the free throw line makes the first. Delaware's lead is back, 52-51. Mosley now 4 of 5 on the season from the free throw line. Mosley's second free throw is good. Got the shooter's roll. You don't get that on the road. You get that at the Bob Carpenter Center. Shooter's touch, and Delaware up two.
Mosley, a terrific foul shooter in high school. It was probably the best part of his game. He was so tough down the stretch, showing some great positive minutes here for Delaware tonight. Best game of the year by Mosley.
Under 8 to play at the Bob Carpenter Center. Hens 0-5 trying to get that first win of the 2014-15 campaign. And Carter bumps Maxwell Lennox. That'll send us to a timeout. The second on Carter and the seventh on Delaware. So we'll have Army basketball when we return. Delaware, though, a two-point advantage at 53-51, 7:44 to play.
We are the champions, setting it off again. Oh, we on fire, we on fire. Running our own campaign, doing the whole shebang. Oh, we on fire, we on fire. Get up, stand up, throw your hands up. Welcome to the other land of dreamers, brothers, sisters, others. Yeah, we all fight like that.
You can now watch all Hens All Access content on any of your devices. Whether you're at the store on your phone or on the couch with your iPad or laptop, Hens All Access live and on-demand content is just a touch away. Not only will live games be available on your mobile devices, they'll also be available in high definition. Best of all, you don't even need an app. Just click over to BlueHens.com on your device and take the Hens anywhere you go.
And a portion of this broadcast brought to you by Concord Pet Food and Supplies. For everything your pet needs, visit ConcordPetFoods.com or any of their 27 locations in the area. I'm Scott Klatskin next to Bill Harmon, Ronnie Vickers producing back to the WDSD studios, and the Hens up by 2, 53-51, 7:44 left in the ballgame.
Delaware doing a much better job of taking care of the basketball. They've gotten a good shot the last six times down the floor. They've been sharing the basketball, allowing Holden and Mosley, when he gets in, to be very creative. Exceptional play by Trevarsky Corbett so far. 4 for 8 from the field.
1-1, front end miss as we return to action by Maxwell. Lennox Harris skies with a rebound. And Army right now shooting just 57% from the free throw line. They're 8 of 15. Mosley pounding the floor, brings it left side. Hanging, shot off the mark, rebounded by Carter, who crashes and saved Mosley that time. Not a good look from the freshman, but Carter was able to get there, get fouled, and get to the free throw line.
I thought one of the keys in the second half was going to be Delaware's ability to get on the offensive glass. They've had good energy. They've just had a little tough luck not being in the right spot. At that time, Eric Carter did a great job of slipping in from the weak side. The missed block out by Kennedy Edwards allows him to get to the foul line.
And remember, in the first half, as Carter makes the first free throw, 4 of 5 on the season is Carter. In the first half, Army was getting those offensive rebounds. They had 5 in the first half. Well, Delaware has matched now the total of offensive boards in the game from the Black Knights, both teams with 7.
It's important here that both Corbett and Harris understand if Carter misses the foul shot, they don't want to climb the back. Delaware is going to, they're in the bonus now, Army, with 7 fouls by Delaware. They've got to be smart here.
Carter doesn't give him an opportunity to go over the back as he makes both free throws. Hens up by 3. It's 54-51, 7:23 left in the second half. Here's Cox with the basketball. Right side, Toomey. Had a look, didn't take it. Goes to Ferguson instead. They run that offense from Ferguson on the block. He challenges Harris, and Harris blocked the shot, got him with the body, though. And this is where Harris has to be careful. He's already got a technical foul once this season. He gets excited, and some referees will take it the wrong way and think that he's showing the referee up. He kind of bounced a couple times, questioned the call. It was the right call, got him with the body. But you love the energy from Barnett Harris, but he's got to keep that part of his game in check.
And for the first time, I noticed Barnett had a smile on his face and not that super serious look that he gets sometimes. And that's when I know he's losing his composure. But that time he was just late in his rotation. But I want to say that Kasman Hayes has done a very good job here in the second half of his man-to-man defense on Kyle Wilson, the exceptional shooter and scorer for Army. He's done a great job of marking him up. They've run some pretty sophisticated stuff, and Hayes has risen to the task.
Ferguson missing on the free throws, and a foul's going to be called on the box out against Delaware. Wow. You rarely see a foul on the box out on a missed free throw.
But I've seen it. Pinkert now for the third time has wrapped his hands
right
behind and held in this case, Kyle Wilson off on the block out. He's got to start there and then end up bringing his hands up, elbows up, and also fingers to the sky. You won't get a foul, plus you're in better position to go rebound the ball.
And you've got to figure, because he's done it earlier in the game, maybe he was warned about it, and that's why the call was made.
It's just bad technique for a good player.
And that's number four on Devon Pinkard. So, unfortunately, he just checked in. He has to check right back out. Kyle Wilson at the free throw line. The last 1-1 for Army, as there's 9 team fouls now for Delaware. And he makes the first. Wilson held in check. And you mentioned it by Kasman Hayes. Only now 4 points in the second half after those 2 free throws.
And you're right. Very rarely do you get that call made in that situation. But I'm sure the officials had told him about it, because I'd seen it happen 2 times in the first half. One resulted in him not being able to get a rebound.
55-53, though, still a Delaware lead despite the free throws from Wilson. Harris in the corner to Corbett. Corbett leans in, draws the contact, can't finish. That's a heady play by a freshman. Didn't like his initial angle, drew the defenders in the air, and got the shot off.
There were 2 smart plays. He recognized and read the screen by Barnett Harris that the defender was cheating over the top. He went back door. Harris also recognized it, dropped the ball off to him, and then Corbett, instead of forcing it right away into the shot blocker, fake, stepped through, and drew the foul, as you so aptly described.
Both teams, though, struggling from the free throw line, as Corbett, an 86% free throw shooter, who misses the first free throw of the season against Villanova on Sunday, misses there. Delaware 13 of 23 from the line.
The other key there was that Kevin Ferguson, the fine post player for Army, got his 4th foul on the Corbett draw.
Ferguson with 4 and Pinkard with 4, 2 key players in this ball game. Now Delaware up 56-53 as Corbett makes the second. They try to go back door. It's off the foot of Barnett Harris and into the hands of Corey Holt, and a turnover for Army. They're 8th.
Barnett Harris did a great job of opening up to the ball, seeing it, was able to get his leg on it there, but without kicking it. A very heady defensive play by Barnett Harris.
It's Holden around a couple screens to the left side, and the ball is stripped by Williams and thrown off the body of Corey Holden as Williams was falling out of bounds. That's a good play by a senior on this Army team.
Mo Williams, also one of the better on-the-ball defenders, along with Maxwell Lennox, did a great job there of forcing Holden away from the basket. He recognized, cut off the angle, and then as he got the steal, threw it off of Holden. Just a very smart play by a smart defender.
That's the 7th steal of the season, leading the team for Williams. Chance to tie on this possession for Army as Wilson drives, and Williams in the corner made the defensive play and now does it on offense. From the corner, we're tied at 56.
Wilson drew the help, which was Corbett. Then he found his teammate Williams in the corner. Corbett with a great closeout, but just too late because he'd been drawn to help on Wilson.
Now Holden, kick out Corbett, corner 3. Can't find the answer, but Carter can on the putback.
That was a split we saw earlier, left to right. Holden finds Corbett, a really good look and a good shot to take, and a great foul by Carter.
3 youngsters on offense touching the ball, all freshmen on that possession. Hens up 58-56, 5:35 remaining. Army going to go to Wilson. Now to Toomey in the corner, in front of the Army bench, back out to their leading scorer, Kyle Wilson, who has 19. It's Jordan at the free throw line, a whistle away from the ball. That's going to be a foul against Delaware, the 10th on the Hens, so free throws coming up for West Point, as Barnett Harris was holding on. And I believe Mo Williams is the player that will shoot the free throws.
Army gets a lot of off-the-ball movement. They do back cuts a la Princeton, but they do a lot more ball screens and handoffs than Princeton does, and they don't typically operate out of the high post. They work through the low post. But Delaware's done a pretty good job of blocking off the cuts, stealing a couple back doors, and keeping very good pressure on Wilson. He really has only had 1 good look this half. Let's credit Kasman Hayes, but also his teammates for helping.
And the struggles continue from the charity stripe. Both teams shooting under 60% in the ball game, as Williams, a 60% free throw shooter, misses the first. Delaware boxing out on the second shot, but it's good. And it's now 58-57. Full court pressure from Army. And they get into Holden. Holden will be able to dribble it up.
Mo Williams, the senior that made a good play the last time on Holden. Let's see if Holden kind of recognizes what Williams is trying to do to him.
Corey Holden centers the basketball. Now to Hayes. Get it down to Jeffers. Jeffers working on Jordan, using the right hand off the mark right, and rebounded by Toomey.
Good look by Mo Jeffers. He loves to work to his left shoulder. Just a tough miss.
Now Cox on the run off the window. Lead back to the Black Knights. It's 59-58.
And that's the experience of Army. Dylan Cox driving the ball down the left-hand side, but working his body back in to use the glass to soften up the shot. A smart play by the junior.
Delaware struggled the final 4 minutes of the first half. Can't have those same struggles to end this ball game. Approaching the four-minute mark. 4:35 remaining. Hayes inside. Good! Plus one! Kasman Hayes with the foul and one. And Delaware has the lead back.
Kasman Hayes recognizing that he had the right angle of the basket. He had Kyle Wilson on him, a pretty good defender, most improved defender on Army's team. But he continued in, and he did a great job of jump stopping and then sliding to his right, which created the positive angle and drew the foul. A great play by Hayes. I like him driving the ball at Army's defense.
Makes the free throw. Hayes in double figures for the sixth straight game to start the season, averaging over 16.5 points per game. And now Harris will check in for Eric Carter, who played very well, had a good follow a couple possessions ago. Now it's Army's chance. Cox, the point guard, on top, right side of Toomey. Toomey had a couple shots early in the game. Haven't seen much from him since. It's Rolo with the basketball to Williams. Extra pass, Cox. Cox back to Williams with 16 to shoot.
Corbett is on Wilson now, Scott, and that's a big matchup.
Now Toomey lets it fly from three, misses, not a good shot, and Holden with the rebound.
And that's key. I thought they had an opportunity to run Wilson off another screen. Corbett, not as clever a defender as Hayes, but a good job by Delaware running down that long rebound.
Under four to go. Holden, top of the key. Williams matched up on him. Holden inside, slicing through. Too much spin, but Jeffers with the back tap. It'll stay with Delaware.
Very rarely do I like a tip ball as an offensive rebounder, but that time he recognized only Delaware players were back. A great play by Mo Jeffers, who I think is playing the best game that I've seen him play in his career at Delaware.
I agree with you. Monte Ross knows it's a big possession, wants to call timeout, will stay right here. As we talk about some of these big guys, Maurice Jeffers, we've seen him do it offensively, that time with the tip out. He's also played Kevin Ferguson very well at times in the low block. We've seen Eric Carter play well, showing his size, getting inside, getting position, scoring. And Sky Johnson, let's not forget him, the freshman 6'8", 240. He's shown some signs of what's to come in his career, all playing good basketball. Carter was 6-5. Jeffers with 7-7. Sky Johnson with 5-3. For Delaware, they've been led by Corey Holden with 13 points and Hayes and Corbett with 11. This is the second game that Chavarsky Corbett has seen double figures.
The difference here in the second half is Delaware's defensive intelligence has been outstanding. They've done a great job, in particular Kasman Hayes on Kyle Wilson. They also got Ferguson in foul trouble and did a really nice job of defending him down on the low block, forcing him to his right shoulder, forcing him into bad angles, then getting him into foul trouble. And I think just the overall composure that Delaware's young players have had have kind of risen up here, and they're playing well beyond their years.
After the timeout by Monte Ross, 20 on the shot clock. Hands a design play, but Holden lost his dribble. Harris comes to get it. Outside right. It's Hayes with the basketball now, looking to get it back to Holden. 11 to shoot for Corey Holden. Flashing is Corbett at the foul line. Corbett with the runner, too strong, fouls his shot, tips it around, and rebounded by the 6'10 Ferguson.
Ferguson reinserted with four fouls, did a good job of positioning inside on Corbett's floater.
Now Cox, what a shot that was. He went left to right through the paint, tucked it, and got it up with the right hand. We're tied at 61. Now Holden has to use a timeout. He couldn't inbound the basketball. Maybe with 2 seconds left on the five count, but the youngster didn't want to turn the basketball over in that spot, and another timeout for Delaware.
I think that was a smart play by Holden. First of all, he could have run along the baseline to improve his angle. But Delaware's got to be cognizant of the fact that Army at times has applied that quick man-to-man pressure, man on the ball at the full court after a make. They needed their other players to be involved in the press break. But a smart timeout by Holden. Also, Delaware's got to help on Cox when he drives the ball. He takes it at a severe angle, and that time Holden actually forced him away, but they probably have to rotate a shot blocker to him to affect that shot.
Hens, though, after using back-to-back timeouts in a game that will probably come down to the final possession, only one timeout remaining. They will be helped at the next whistle by an under 4 minute media timeout coming up. After the timeout, Pinkert in the game. You figure he'll get in for some offense, playing with the four fouls, and come back out for defense at the whistle.
Well, one of the problems was on the last out of bounds, Holden was taking the ball out and probably should have been inbounds trying to get himself free.
On with the basketball now, though. 26 to shoot as he brings it to the right wing. Jeffers on top. A mismatch inside as Edwards is guarding Harris, but they don't get it to him. Hayes now on the left wing to Pinkert. Inside the paint. Power dribble inside. Ball on the rim. Doesn't fall through. But he was fouled, and Pinkert will shoot two free throws for the lead when we come back. Just 2:34 remaining here at the Bob Carpenter Center. The score is tied. Delaware and Army 61 apiece.
Delaware Athletics sponsors 21 teams comprised of over 600 student-athletes and will award nearly 230 scholarships costing $9.5 million this year. Blue Hen fans across the nation contribute to the University of Delaware Athletic Fund each year. Your contributions provide scholarships, equipment, and academic support so UD student-athletes can compete in the sport they love and receive a college education.
Rush hour or relax hour? It's your choice. Dark. Moving forward.
I'm here because this is my home. Delaware pride. You can say I have that. It's bigger now. The state is across my chest. Now it's about all of us. Now I am a Blue Hen. Experience it.
We're here at the Bob Carpenter Center. We've been used to excitement over the years at the Bob, and Delaware delivering again. The 0-5 Blue Hens trying to get win number one on the year against a 5-1 Army Black Knights team out of the Patriot League. One of the favorites to win the Patriot League. It's 61 apiece. I'm Scott Klatskin with Bill Harmon. And now the young Hens a chance down the stretch to gain some experience.
I think the most important thing is they need to continue to play that tough defense, mark up Kyle Wilson, make sure he does not get any good looks. Continue to defend Ferguson inside well. They've got to be able to make their foul shots down the stretch. And they need to run good offense. They don't need to shoot right away, but they need to take the best available shot whenever it comes in the shot clock situation. But more importantly, make sure they get back on defense and take care of the basketball.
Pinkert makes one of two. Now just one of four in the ballgame from the stripe is Devon Pinkert. Delaware 18 of 29. Now Wilson on the drive. Hayes, who's played Wilson so well in this second half, called for the hand check, and Wilson will shoot two from the stripe. He doesn't miss much from there. 82% on the year.
And unfortunately, Casman Hayes has got to realize if he's going to send Wilson to the basket, especially with his left hand, he had Pinkert rotating. You never want to foul the driver in that situation. Send him into the help and see what happens.
Wilson, free throw good off of his arm. 20 points now for Kyle Wilson, averages 21 points per game. 2013 Patriot League Rookie of the Year. Now a junior, led the Patriot League in scoring a season ago.
Wilson has shown great patience tonight as Casman Hayes has done a great job, in particular in the second half. He never panicked, he hasn't taken a bad shot, and he's provided good defense at the other end.
Wilson makes them both, lead back to Army. Pinkert's got to know he can move, throws it into Hayes in traffic. Hayes gets it, saves it to Pinkert on the sideline. What a play by Casman Hayes, showing that leaping ability and keeping the possession in the hands of the Blue Hens. Now it's Holden. Crossover on Williams. Crosses over again to Hayes. Baseline into traffic. Can't find the angle as Ferguson was there to rearrange the shot. Army up by one with the basketball. 2 minutes left.
Hayes just a little out of control there. Needed to get his shoulders parallel to the backboard to finish.
Now it's Cox to Wilson for three, around and down. Kyle Wilson has the last 5 points of the ball game. And Army up by four now. That's a huge shot for Wilson, his sixth three-pointer.
Well, one thing Delaware might want to do is play no help off of Wilson in the corner. Force Cox to drive into one of the bigs who can challenge his shot. Do not allow Wilson to get the ball on a split and kick. That time, he was a catch and shoot. It was a great release. It was a very difficult shot, and he was challenged. But unfortunately, a good player like that's going to make big shots, especially at big moments. He wants the ball in his hands. Great patience. I can see why he will probably be the best player in the Patriot League.
Hens need an answer here, though. 66-62. Hens down by four. It was tied at 61. Holden. Bring the ball up the floor, guarded by Army's best defender, Mo Williams. Screen comes from Jeffers to the left side. Holden now crosses using the right inside. Shot partially blocked by Wilson. Holden gets it back, but Ferguson blocks it. And it's back to Army. No one touched the ball but Holden on that possession. And now Monte Ross, a technical foul from chatting a little bit too much with one of the officials.
Well, I can see why Coach Ross is upset. He's put all his emotion. His team has played extremely hard tonight, especially for their first home game. Holden, again, I think at times takes the ball a little too deep when the shot blocker presents him, and that was Kevin Ferguson, who is very long-armed and leads Army in foul shooting. In block shots.
Delaware standing at half court watching Kyle Wilson make the free throw. Six straight points from Kyle Wilson. It was tied at 61, now 67-62. And all have come off the right hand of Kyle Wilson.
Well, this is a veteran team, and they have a great player in Kyle Wilson. He drove the ball, and Hayes fouled him on the drive. That put him at the foul line. They split and kicked. They helped off of Wilson in the corner, and he drains the three, and now he makes the two technical free throws.
It's a big technical foul call, though, in that spot. Because now you've made it a two-possession game with two threes being necessary, and Delaware, 8 of 20 from three-point range in this ball game, but not a good three-point shooting team on the season, just 29%. Now Army will hold with 20 left to shoot, a minute 5 left to play, and Cox with the basketball deep left side. 8 to shoot now for Cox, brings to the right side. Hens need a stop here, 5 to shoot. It's Wilson, 3 to shoot. Leans in, trying to get contact and cannot. Nice try by Hayes to avoid Wilson leaning in. An air ball and a shot clock violation. 48 seconds left. Delaware down 6 with the basketball.
Very clever play by Kyle Wilson. I wish we had a telestrator to show that. He knew he had Hayes charging at him a little late, tried to square up and draw it. Hayes also very smartly dodged the potential jump in foul.
Heads need something quick or a 3. Hayes inside, shot blocked by Wilson right into traffic. And Delaware has just gone one-on-one the last 3 possessions, and it's led to 3 block shots by Army. Army gets the basketball back, and we'll see more free throws from the Black Knights.
Taking the ball in too deep, trying to create a foul situation, and I admire them for doing that, but if the first one doesn't work, you're probably better off running some other offense. Dump the ball into the bigs. They had good success with that. Army is a pretty good defensive team, especially around the rim with Ferguson as the shot blocker and effector. I think Delaware just kind of went to the well too many times with the same play, and now they're going to go down probably for a loss.
35 seconds left. Delaware down 6, and we've seen crazier things, especially last season at the Bob Carpenter Center. Don't want to count anything out, but Bill, the first taste this late in a ball game for Delaware, a chance to win a basketball game. They put on a good show, but it does feel like Army down the stretch with some more experienced players, Kyle Wilson being one of them, were able to put it away.
Well, Wilson and Ferguson have really made some big plays here, and Cox as well. Yeah. When they needed some scoring, Cox actually attacked the basket and had 2 bank shots in to keep them within striking distance, and then Wilson has put them ahead. I think we've all got to remember, and this is not an excuse, this is reality, Delaware is playing without their 2 most experienced players, Marvin King Davis, beset with a hamstring injury, and of course, Kyle Anderson, the fine shooter who really provides a lot of leadership, the only senior on the team, not being able to participate because of the hand injury.
Wilson makes the first, misses the second, Mosley to the rim, a quick 2 for Delaware, 69-64 now the count, 26.7. And Army wanted the timeout, not being awarded one, I believe.
Well, no, it's their ball. They could take the timeout if they wanted.
Or Delaware wanted to call? A whistle was blown. I believe Delaware wanted the timeout.
Delaware was trying to call the timeout, but because the ball was quickly possessed by Army, they did not allow it.
So Army will inbound, running the baseline is Williams. And they don't want to foul Wilson. Wilson holding on the ball, and they do. It's Hayes who reaches in. They'll send Kyle Wilson to the free throw line. Wilson's gotten all of Army's points since the game was tied at 61. It was 2:34 remaining, 61 apiece. Wilson has 8 straight points for Army, 69-64 is the count, 24 seconds left.
And I know Coach Ross is going to be very disappointed because Delaware put out such a great effort. But I can find a number of positives to take out of this game. And I know it's important, especially at the collegiate level, to win. But I'm talking about long-term down the road. This team learned a lot from this game. This is a very fine Army team. They're very well coached. They've got two outstanding players. One in particular, great player, I think, for this level, in Kyle Wilson. And they did everything but win this game tonight. And I think they're going to find a lot of things to see on the tape. They're going to lead them to some victories later on.
Mosley again at the rim, missing. Jeffers rebound, put back. There's one of the positives. Mo Jeffers. And now Delaware gets the timeout that they wanted last possession. And stops the clock at 15.6. Delaware down 71-66. Hens will need a steal off the inbound or keep it away from Kyle Wilson, as other free throw shooters for Army have not fared very well. 11 of 21 Army was shooting from the stripe before Wilson down the stretch here.
Mo Jeffers, I think, has played extremely well tonight. He's been opportunistic. He played well defensively. He played within himself. He made a couple of very senior-like decisions with the basketball when he might have earlier on in his career forced it. He's been very active on the glass, and I think he and Barnett Harris, along with the young bigs, are really starting to come into their own, and this is going to reap them rewards much further down the road, especially once we get into CAA play. So we've got to have some patience with this team. Young teams are going to have trouble closing out halves and end of games, and that's what we saw. And the more veteran team in Army kind of rose to the occasion, in particular Kyle Wilson.
The effort was there for Delaware. The shame of it is that they played well enough to win a basketball game. Won't get the win, but the message to the team has got to be, if you keep playing like this, if you keep playing at this level, the wins are going to come.
Absolutely, and when we get back Marvin King Davis and Kyle Anderson, yeah, it's even going to help more just having that senior leadership, having someone to go out, one senior and one junior, someone to go to in the clutch. Put a lot of pressure on Holden. I thought he played an extremely smart game throughout the entire part, just a couple of probably ill-fated decisions down the stretch of attacking the shot blocker, not getting any fouls.
Harris on the inbound, and they get it into Wilson. Wilson is found by either Harris or Hayes, who are both there on the double team, and Wilson can add to his total.
And this is the experienced team showing forth. They found a way when Delaware was pressuring them to always get the ball in the hands of Kyle Wilson. He's got to be face guarded. They need to take him out of the play, double team him, and make it be inbounded to someone else, at least take a chance. Wilson is not going to miss any down the stretch.
Wilson's jump shot, free throw is good. Wilson now 11 straight for Army. It was 61 apiece, now 72-66. Still two possession game, and now a three possession game as the second one goes through. That was Delaware's probably last shot. That one had to miss. Holding down the floor with 10 seconds left, gets inside, leaves it for Mosley. Dropped by Mosley, picked up by Mosley. Now slings it over to Hayes. Hayes with 4 seconds, lets the three fly. It's good for Kasman Hayes. Multiple three-pointers now in every game this season. Edwards ahead. It goes to Ferguson with 1 second left, and this one is final. Delaware fights hard, scratches and claws, but Kyle Wilson too much in the end. 73-69, Army wins it. They improved to 6-1 on the season. Delaware 0-6 on the 2014-15 campaign, but their best effort of the season came tonight on their home floor. We'll talk about it in the American Spirit postgame show coming up next. Brought to you by the American Spirit Federal Credit Union in Newark, Middletown, and Dover, and online at AmericanSpirit.org. Don't go anywhere. We'll have final stats for you. We'll also talk with head coach Monte Ross. A good effort by the Hens, a young team learning, and this was a night where they gained a lot of experience and, I think, confidence against a good Army team that I think we'll see in the NCAA tournament later on this year. Final 73-69. We'll be back in a moment from the Bob Carpenter Center on 94.7 WDSD.